Episode number 11. Under this episode, we discuss about product mix and pricing strategies. The product mix is a combination of products manufactured or sold by the same organization. Generally, companies offer an assortment of related or unrelated products to the markets instead of focusing on a single product to strengthen their presence in the market and increase profitability. Smaller or medium firms usually offer products that are related to each other, while bigger ones go for large scale diversification. For example, Herbals and a comparatively smaller enterprise basically deals with cosmetics and beauty products, while Gains like Reliance Group of Group and Tata Industries have their presence in varied field like telecom, processed food, consumer goods, etc. Dealing with multiple products enable a firm to expand its consumer base and spread risk among its various offerings. The product mix includes both product lines and product items. Product line, that is, the product line is a group of products that are closely related, either because they satisfy a class of need or used together or sold to the same customer group or marketed through the same type of outlets or fall within given price ranges of that are considered a unit because of marketing technical or end use considerations. For example, the Sunsilk's shampoo and other conditioners constitute a product line. Then product item, it is a distinct unit within the product line that is separate from others on basis of color, size, price and other distributes. For example, Sunsilk thick and long shampoo is a product unit distinguishable for other items in the product range. The next concept is structure of product mix. There are four structure of product mix. First one is the width. The width of the product mix means the number of different products lines found within the company. Thus, the breadth is measured by the number of product lines carried. For example, Bajaj Group has a number of subsidiaries under its producing bulbs, fluorescent lights, mixer and grinders, motorcycle, pressure cookers and etc. And then depth of the product mix. Next one, next is the depth. Depth of the product mix refers to the average number of items offered by the company within each product line. It is measured by assortment of size, colors, models, prices and quality offered within each product line. For instance, Hindustan Unilever offers a number of variants like Lux Fresh, Splash, Strawberry and Cream, etc. The next is consistency. The consistency of product mix points out how closely related the various product lines are in terms of consumer behavior, production requirements, distribution channels, or in some other way. For example, the products produced by the General Electric Company have an overall consistency in the most product involve electricity in one way or other. So, according to the Flipkotler, all three dimensions of product mix have market, the rationale by increasing the width of product mix, the company hopes capitalize on its goods, reputation and skills in present market. By increasing the depth of its product mix, the company hopes to entice patronage of buyers of widely differing fastness and needs. By increasing the consistency of product mix, the company hopes to acquire an unparalleled reputation in a particular area of endeavor. The product types of new products. Business firms always try to find a new market by innovation and research. They create new product to satisfy changing demand of customers. We can see new product, especially in the field of electronic and computer. New product lines. The new product lines allow a company to enter established market line, example LCD televisions. The next concept is product hierarchy, that is a need family. It is a core need that underlies the existence of product family. These products satisfy a core need of the group of people or of an individual. They are called products from the need family. For example, hunger is core need which is satisfied by food. And then next, product family, that is these consist of all product classes that can satisfy a core need with reasonable effectiveness. It comprises of areas of product within this group which compete with one another to satisfy the same need. These are family of product satisfying the same need. For example, fast food, snacks, vegetables and etc. And the next one is product class. It is a group of product within the product family recognized as having a certain functional coercence. A group of product within this family of products having similar characteristics are labeled as product class or product category. For example, fast food. And then next one is a product levels of product. The need of customers vary according to their economic conditions and social situations. As customers grow economically, they require enhanced product that can satisfy their current needs. The organization addresses the varied needs of customers by producing a same product at different levels. Each level adds some valuable features in a product. For example, mobile phones come with different features and functions to satisfy varied needs of customers. Then if a customer wishes to use mobile phone only for communication purpose, so he purchase can buy very simple mobile phone. However, if the customer wishes to use mobile phone in for communication, business and entertainment purpose, so he buy mobile phone with additional features. That is let's now we discuss different levels of products in brief. First of all, core product. It includes the key feature of a product. It forms the basis for other product offering levels. For example, the key feature of a car is to travel from one place to another. Therefore the simple and a small car with no additional features is a core product. The next, basic product. It includes some added benefit along with the basic features of a product. For example, a clean and spacious car is the basic product. Then next, expected product. It refers to a product that is desired by customers. It varies from individual to individual depending on other factors such as the social class. For example, a customer buying a car may expect an air conditioner and a music system in it. So that is expected product. Next one is augmented product. It includes additional attributes of a product as compared to products offered by competitors. The additional benefit satisfy rational customers more in terms of value. For example, a car may have special inbuilt features such as LCD TV, refrigerator. And then next one is the potential product. It compares the benefit derived from the product in future with the current product. It creates a value for customers beyond their expectations. For example, a high technology gadget car with good ambitions and comfort is a potential product. The next concept is product design. That is the changes in product. That is the design largely dictated by whether they would improve the products. That is a greater sales and this over the accompanying cost. Changing in design are also subject to cultural pressures. The more culture bound the product is, for example food, the more adaptations is necessary. Most product fall in between the spectrum of standardization or adaptation, etc. Then the application the product is put to also affect the design. In agricultural implement, a mechanized cultivator may be convenience item in UK. The next concept is pricing. That is the product pricing introduction. Pricing the product or service is one of the most important business decisions you will make. You must offer your products for a price your target market is willing to pay, and one that produces a profit for your company, or you won't be in business for long. There are many approaches to pricing, included scientific and unscientific. Here is one of framework for making pricing decisions that takes into account your cost, the effect of competition and the customer's perception value. Then cost is the total of the fixed and variable expenses. Cost to you to manufacture or offers your product or services. And the next price is the selling price per unit that customers pay for your product or service. So that the price you set the cost to the customer, ideally it should be higher than the cost you incurred in producing the product. How the customer perceives the value of the product determine the maximum price customers will pay. This is sometimes described as the price the market will bear. Perceived value is created by an established reputation, marketing messages, packaging and sales environment. An obvious and important component of perceived value is the comparison customers and the prospects make between you and your competition. Then physical offers may be required to obtain some services, especially if the customer must come to the service factory and the delivery entails self-service. The sensory cost may include putting up the noise, unpleasant smell, draft, excessive heat and cold, uncomfortable seating, visually unappealing environment, and even unpleasant taste. One of the reasons that many children dislike health care. The pricing, that is the pricing of the product, the right price is one of the important determinants of business success. Right price, however, doesn't mean a low price. What is the right price? It depends upon a number of factors like the nature of other elements of marketing mix, nature of market including demand and competition. A price policy is a guideline set up by the top management to bring about optimum product market integration. It is that sharp weapon by which the marketer can encourage or discourage competition. A price is the amount one pays for a good or a service. An idea. Price is the amount of which a product, service or an idea is exchanged or offered for sale regardless of its worth or value to the potential purchaser. Without price, there is no marketing in the society. To a manufacturer, price represent quantity of money or goods and services in a better trade received by the firm or seller. To a customer, it represent sacrifice and hence is a perception of the value of the product. And then pricing buyers and sellers view. In general terms of price is a component of an exchange of transactions that takes place between two parties and refers to what must be given up by one party, that is a buyer, in order to obtain something offered by another party is a seller. In fact, the price means different things to different participants in an exchange. That is the buyer's point of view. For those making a purchase, such as final customers, price refers to what must be given up to obtain benefit. In most cases, what is given up is financial consideration, that is money, exchange for acquiring access to a goods and services, but the financial consideration is not always what the buyer gives up. And then next, seller's point of view. The sellers in transactions price reflect the revenue generated for each product sold and thus is an important factor in determining profit. For marketing organizations, price also serves as a marketing tool and is a key element in marketing promotions. For example, most retailers highlight product pricing in their advertising campaign. And the next, pricing. The main objectives of pricing followed by different firms. Pricing is not an end in itself, but a means to achieve marketing objective of the firm. Therefore, the pricing strategy of a firm should be designed to achieve specific objectives. Like other operating objectives, the objectives of pricing are derived from the overall objectives of the firm. The basic objective of a firm are survival and growth. The objective of pricing should be clearly defined, because without clear-cut objectives, a sound price structure cannot be developed. So in practice, very few firms define their pricing objectives in unambiguous terms. The specific objective of pricing may vary from firm to firm. The main objectives of pricing followed by different firms are as follows. That is, to achieve target rate of return on investment. That is, firms following this objective design their pricing strategy in such a way that will yield desired return on total investment. That is, rate of return refers to the amount of net profit divided by investment or capital employed. In order to fix the price, the firm estimates the amount of total profit required to earn the expected rate of return. That is the figure total profit divided by average sales volume gives profit margin per unit. The company can calculate price as under. That is, the target rate of return is an important pricing objective, and increasing number of firms follow this goal due to several reasons. However, target rate of return pricing may not be feasible in all conditions. This goal can be achieved by firms which are industry leaders or which sell in a protected market. Some firms may attempt to achieve target return on sales during short run. The next objective is price stabilization. That is, this goal is adopted in industries having few firms in an oligopolistic situation where one firm is very big and all others are small. The big firm act as the price leader and other firms follow it. All the firms try to avoid price wars. No firm is willing to cut its prices for fear of retailing by other firms. In order to avoid fluctuations in prices, they may even forgo maximizing profit during the period of scarce supply or prosperity. And then next objective is target share of the market. In an expanding market, market share is a better indicator of a firm's success than the target rate of return. When the market has potential growth, a firm earning a target rate of return may in fact be decaying of its share of the market, it's decreasing. That is, next one is facing competition under conditions of intense competition. A firm may seek to meet or prevent competition. It may fix prices at a very low level, even below cost, to eliminate its competitors or to prevent the entry to new firm in the market. Some firms follow this practice while introducing a new product. This goal is not very popular and cannot be adopted on a regular basis. The next objective is profit maximization. Traditionally, every organization involved in profit maximization is considered to be the objective of pricing. The classical economic theory suggests the fixation of prices in such a way that a marginal cost is equal to marginal revenue where profit are maximized. Even today, some firms are not very conscious of social responsibilities and try to maximize profits. But in recent years, there has been a change in philosophy of business and profit maximization is not considered rational business behavior. In practice, no firm states explicitly in profit maximization. It is pricing objective due to fear of public criticism and government regulations. The next objective is improving public image. The another objective of pricing may be enhance the firm's public image. The firm may launch a premium product at a high price for this purpose. Alternatively, it may offer the new product at a low price to appeal to the common buyer. The pricing policy to achieve the goal of full capacity utilization, market explorations and diversification, etc. The pricing objectives may be classified into three categories. That is, growth in sales, market share, predetermined profit level. And then pricing is a most important thing. When marketers talk about that they do as part of their responsibilities for marketing products and a task associated with setting price. Some reasons of pricing include a most flexible marketing mix variable, the next concept is pricing, that is various kinds of pricing for their various products. First one is odd pricing. It may be price ending an odd number. Bata shoe company pricing one of its pair shoes at ₹299.95 is an example of odd pricing. Such pricing is adopted by sellers of specialty or convenient goods. And then next, psychological pricing. The price under this method are fixed at a full number. The price settlers feel such a price has an apparent psychological significance from the viewpoint. That differs from the concept of odd pricing in that the cure doesn't necessarily have any segment positively included. The next, customary prices. Such prices are fixed by custom. For example, soft drinks are priced by their customary basis. Such a pricing is usually adopted by chain stores. The next, pricing at prevailing prices. It is a kind of pricing is undertaken to meet the competition. It is also called pricing at the market. Such a strategy presumes a market in elasticity of demand below the current price. The next, prestige pricing. It is a kind of pricing. Many customers judge the quality of a product by its price. In their opinion, lower priced products is inferior and higher priced product is superior. This pricing is applied generally to luxurious goods only. And then price lining. This policy of pricing is usually found among retailers. Technically, it is closely related to both psychological and customary prices. Under this policy, the pricing decisions are made only initially, and such fixed prices remain constant over a long period. Then next, geographic pricing. That is, it is a method of pricing. The manufacturer to follow sometimes adopt different prices in different market without creating any hill will among customers. For example, petrol is priced depending upon the distance from the storage area to the retail outlet. And the next one is FOB, free on board pricing. That is, here the buyer will have to incur the cost of transit, and in the latter the price quoted is inclusive of transit charges. The next one is dual pricing. The dual pricing is also one of the pricing method. The manufacturer sells the same product at two or more different prices in the same market. It is dual market pricing. This is possible only different brands are marketed. It is adopted in railways where passengers are charged differently for the same journey and traveling in different classes. This is also referred to as discriminatory pricing. And then next one is administered pricing. This applies to the practice of pricing the products for the marketers not on the basis of cost, competitive pressures or the loss of supply and demand, but purely on the basis of the policy decisions of the sellers. That is, these kinds of price remain unchanged for a substantial period of time. That is, a long term, the price cannot be changed.